I'm calling on Republicans and Democrats immediately to institute, to get to Washington and institute the death penalty for drug dealers. You will no longer have a problem. If you look at countries through all throughout the world, no matter where you go, the only ones that don't have a drug problem are those that institute the death penalty for drug dealers. China has no drug problem. No, China has no drug problem. You know, we're becoming a drugged out country. I don't know if you know it or not. We have drugs at a level that's never been seen.
So basically nothing he said there is true, but let's take him at his word that he believes we need to be far harsher on those who deal drugs, those who take drugs. It is a problem that cannot be taken lightly. In fact, even the death penalty should be in play. Well, an old Donny boy is gonna be interested in some of the reporting that's come out recently about the situation in the Trump White House when it comes to drugs. And you may know the story that I'm talking about here. It's been coming out in dribs and drabs over the course of the past few weeks about how casual drugs were being prescribed or not prescribed, just handed out. But what you may not know is how willing many in the White House were to roast Donald Trump as the cause of people's developing drug problems. So we're gonna jump through all of that. But a lot of this interview is coming out from, there's a Defense Department Inspector General report, as well as interviews with people who served in the White House. And what they're saying is that both speed and Xanax were just being handed out willy-nilly, like Pop-Tarts perhaps. The stimulant was routinely given to staffers who needed an energy boost after a late night. I think that's what speed is for, when you had to work a little late, or just a pick-me-up to handle another day at what's described as a uniquely stressful job. And I agree, working for Donald Trump is probably pretty stressful. One of the former officials told Rolling Stone that the White House was awash in speed. So I'm assuming the death penalty is gonna be being doled out by Donald Trump as freely as the speed was, because we can't allow druggies like this to be running our government. Apparently, samples of the stimulant were passed around for those who contributed lines to Trump speeches. Like as a reward, is this Pavlovian conditioning or something? Like, you give me a good racist line, I give you some poppers or something. If they work late on foreign policy initiatives, which I think means the Muslim ban, or those who were coping with bad media inquiries, you just need some speed to deal with that. But like, if this doesn't make it seem ridiculous enough, it was described by one anonymous source as kind of like the Wild West. Things were pretty loose. Whatever someone needs, we were gonna fill this, which is a really weird way to say that. But then you might wonder, but why is it so necessary? There's gotta be a good reason. And a good reason was provided by an anonymous source who said, I had a lot going on in my life and I wanted some, which is not, that's not super convincing. Yeah, most people who take drugs wanted some, but why? I have follow-up questions. In any event, senior staffers often took Xanax with alcohol, which I think is specifically the way you're not supposed to take it, but that's how they coped. And it was in fact coping. One former senior administration official, who unfortunately is anonymous here, said, you try working for him and not chasing pills with alcohol. Damn. I want you to bear in mind, Donald Trump did almost nothing as president. They passed a tax bill. They banned a religion. They locked up some kids, but that was mostly the border patrol. What was going on in there in the absence of policy that was so unbearable that they were mixing in a dangerous fashion pills and alcohol? We may never know, but we do know that the Trump White House had the highest turnover in 40 years. And honestly, I'm not surprised by that at all. Now, follow-up question, and this one has legal consequences. Who is prescribing all of these drugs? Well, first of all, a lot of the drugs were not being prescribed, and that's where theoretically the law should maybe get involved. They were literally just dealing drugs willy-nilly. Two different sources have confirmed that it was basically like finals on a college campus. Adderall, Xanax, Speed were just being handed out without prescriptions. But those who were being prescribed, there's a lot of reason to believe that it was Ronnie Jackson. who, based on his media appearances recently, might be doing a little bit of the old self-prescribing. I'm not saying anything. I'm just saying the dude sweats a lot in his interviews. Now, he is lashing out at this with tweets like this, saying the Rolling Stone is a liberal rag used as a propaganda tool for far-left zealots. They never get tired of lying. It's another hit piece, morons. But like, the sources are coming from inside the White House. It wasn't just Rolling Stone people. There are so many people who worked for Donald Trump who are so ready to tell their story in book form if they can, to cash in, but to, you know, this interviewer if necessary. In either case, there was obviously a big problem of drugs. And under a more vigorous, angrier, more vindictive Donald Trump second term, one would imagine the drug problem is going to be even worse. And if that's the case, you know, maybe the death penalty. I'm not saying anything, but Donald Trump is.